Hey everyone, this is Anne for Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to go over how to select things in Photoshop. So I've got a few different ways that I usually use, and there are a ton of different ways to do this, but these are my three favorite ways. I downloaded this image from Etsy, and I have that link in the description. She's sold out right now, but it's an awesome image, isn't it? So maybe she'll make some more. Okay, so first, I'm going to use the magic wand tool, which is W on your keyboard. And depending on your tolerance, which is set right up here, you can sometimes get a pretty good selection using this. You can hold shift and keep clicking on places. You can change your tolerance. And if you have contiguous checked, that means it won't select all the yellow all over the place. It'll just select what is touching the area. Usually I get it to about this point, and we'll go ahead and zoom in a little on this. And then I hit Q, and this will change everything. This is a quick mask, and it kind of changes everything to this red tone. So I'm going to hit Q again. Now, to get the red on the flower, which is what we want, we need to inverse this selection, which is Shift-Command-I or Shift-Control-I on a PC. Now hit Q again, and we have the red here. Now, the Q, which is this, the quick selection, uses white and black to help you with your selection. So I'm going to hold Control and Option and resize my brush a little bit. And hit B for brush if you haven't done that already. I'm going to switch this, so I'm going to hit X. And now with your B tool, you can fill in. And what this is doing, it's helping you to select. It's like brushing a selection on. So I'm going to get it a little better than what the magic wand tool did. This isn't perfect. I'm going to hold Control Option and reduce the size of my brush a little bit. Okay. So now we have a little bit better selection. Hit Q again, and now you can see your selection. Now hit Shift-Command-I to invert that, and now hit Command-J, and this will give you just the flower by itself. We'll Option and click the eyeball, and you can see our selection now. So you'd have to clean this up a little bit. It's not perfect. So that is the first method, just using the magic wand and clicking the quick mask back and forth to get your selection perfect. If you were to move this flower, I'm going to hit V for the move tool and move it. You would have to actually go in here on the layer and fill this in with a background color. You can try doing a content aware fill. So we'll do fill. Content aware. Okay, it didn't quite do what I was expecting, but hey, that's not bad. I would probably just go ahead and use the clone stamp to fill in with a dark color like in the background over there. But now this is separated and we can move it, we can turn it. In this case, having that black around the edge is probably not going to matter if you're keeping it on a dark background like it would be. I'm going to hide that, and then I'm going to go ahead and recolor this with the S tool. I'm going to hold Option and click an area and then just fill this in with a background image. And every time I click off, I'm holding Option so that I get a new place to sample from. Okay. And then maybe we can correct this with the healing brush. I'm going to hold Control and Option and pull to the left to get my brush size smaller. And we'll Option click. And this kind of averages the areas so they're not so very copy and paste looking. And I think this is good enough. And now we'll show this flower. Maybe we can move it down. Oops. Maybe we can move it down here and rotate it a little bit. Anything we'd want to do, we can do that now because it's separated. All right, so that is the first method. That is the quick mask and magic wand method. Now I want to kind of show you a way to use channels to do something similar. Here are my channels down here. And if I hit Command 3, I can see the red only channel. I can see green, and I can see blue. And you want to choose the channel that is most different, like with the most contrast. So I want to isolate this, let's isolate this red flower. If I hit Command 3, it's pretty well isolated. It's bright compared to the background. Command 4, it kind of blends in with the background. And Command 5, it really blends in. So we want Command 3, which is just the red channel. So I'm going to pull this down and duplicate the red channel. And now it's the only one showing. Then I'll hit Command L to bring up levels. And we'll kind of mess with this to get it even more contrasty. At this point, I'm going to go ahead and Command and click on the picture of the red copy. We'll turn the layer back on. Okay, so you can see what our selection is. I'm going to inverse this, Shift Command I, and then hit Q. And now we can do that same thing. As long as you're on the brush tool and you have a black fill, you can just go ahead and fill in those areas that it's not selecting. The edge, it pretty well has a pretty good edge on it. You can switch your colors here and hit X, and then get rid of all the stuff around it, like these things. And I just kind of get a little bit around it like this. Maybe get these out of here. And then I hit Q again and inverse Shift Command I. Make sure you're on your background layer and you can hit Command J. And we'll option click the eyeball to see what we've got. Okay, so we've got a selection here. I'm just going to use my L tool to kind of draw around this. My computer's going a little slow right now because I have movie stuff recording. Now click Shift Command I and delete. And now you have just that flower. And you can move it around as you'd want. And you can clean up the edge a little bit by just deleting as you need. This is probably my favorite way to really get something cut out of an image. The third way, which is probably the most accurate, but also the most time consuming, is to use your pen tool. If you hit P, you can draw right around the edge like this. I hold option and click your last spot to get a new pass started. So we'll just do this real quick. Maybe move that one in. I used my arrow keys right there to move that point over. And, we will go ahead and go around the edge here like this. And I usually go in a little bit so that I don't get that background color in the part that I'm trying to trace with my pen. Okay, so we've got a path here. So now we need to go to Paths, which is right over here, and double click and rename this. Doesn't matter what it's named, but that's a way to save it. And now we can Command click the picture and we have a selection. I'll get back on my background layer and hit Command J. And now we have that completely isolated. And of course, if you wanted it to stay in the same spot, you would want to fill in the background behind it with similar stuff from the background, like we did up at the top. Okay, so those are the three ways that I like to cut things out, isolate things, and select them. If you guys have a favorite way of doing this, please let me know in the comments section. And if you like this video, please click the like button. Thanks, guys.